Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good day to all of you. So in this section, we will be looking at the problems of inequality. So basically, when you have inequality problem, you will get the solution set of an inequality where it contains the set of all values that make the statement true. For example, this is the inequality problem, x less than negative 1. So the solution to that can be easily given in terms of a graph. So this is the graph of a real number line. So when x is less than negative 1, you're talking about the area here starting from negative 1 but does not include negative 1, and that's why it is an open circle. So less than negative 1, that means you are going in this direction, so less than negative 1. So the solution to x can be, for example, negative 3.5 or negative 20.666. So whatever values, as long as, you know, x is less than negative 1. Now, to solve an inequality, it is similar to solving an equation, except that you must remember, when you multiply or divide both sides of an inequality by a negative number, then you must reverse the inequality symbol. Now, to illustrate that idea, I'm going to show you the reason why the inequality symbol must be reversed. So this is a simple example. Let's say we have this statement where 3 is less than, I don't know, 10. This statement is true. 3 is indeed a number that is less than 10. Now, if I multiply both sides with a negative number, let's say I multiply that with negative 2, what happens is that 3 times negative 2, and if I don't reverse the symbol, I follow the original symbol, then it will be 10 times negative 2. So the answer that I'll get is negative 6 less than negative 20. And the answer here is no longer true because negative 6 is a number bigger than negative 20. Now, why am I having this problem? Because when I multiplied with a negative value, negative number, I did not change the symbol. I did not reverse the symbol. So the symbol must be reversed when you multiply the inequality or when you divide this inequality with a negative number. So the symbol must be reversed. And then by doing that only, you will have a true statement. Okay. Now, next, solve negative 4x less than 24. So in order to solve it, I have to divide this inequality with negative 4 on the left hand side and the right hand side. So negative 4x divided with negative 4. Similarly, on the left hand side, 24 divided with negative 4. And since you divide that with a negative number, the inequality symbol must be reversed. So next, the solution is x greater than negative 6. And of course, you can check your solution and see that this is true. Okay. So these are some examples given to illustrate how you can actually change how you write the inequality statement. So these are a few examples. This is by using graph. You can visualize this problem, this inequality statement using graph. X greater than 5, and this is using interval notation. Okay, so you use the either round bracket or square bracket. Round bracket is to denote that the number is not included, but square bracket is to represent that particular number is included in the as a solution. Okay, so as an example, x less than 3. Now, in terms of interval notation, it can be written as negative infinity and 3. Okay, it is less than 3, so it is going in the left direction. And for this one, it can be represented as negative 3 and 7. So here the square bracket is used because it includes value negative 3 and 7. For this one, x greater than or equal to negative 2, that means it can go on to infinity but not include infinity. And for this one, x less than or equal to 2, so negative infinity and 2, all here can be represented by a union. X greater than or equal to 6, that means we have 6 and infinity. Okay, next we are going to solve the inequality given here. And it looks complicated, slightly complicated, but you can actually focus or divide that into two parts. First, you can solve this part, okay, and then the second part will be, and then we can focus on the solving the second part. So the second part is this one, okay. Okay, we can start off with any of those two. So let's say we start off with this one. Okay, 3x minus 2 less than 2. Therefore, 3x less than 2 plus 2. So 3x less than 4. Okay, I'm going to get the value of x. So divide with 3. But I can maintain this symbol because it is a positive number. You divide it with the positive number, so you will get 4 over 3. Okay, next. So this part now, 3x minus 2 greater than negative 6. 3x greater than negative 6 plus 2. 3x greater than negative 4. Again, in order to get x, I have to divide the whole inequality with 3. So x greater than negative 4 over 3. I do not need to reverse the symbol because I just divided the whole inequality with a positive number. Okay, so how do we graph the solution? So now let's graph the solution. So this could be 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Could be negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. So negative 4 over 3 is basically 1.333, less than 1.5. So maybe I can say that this is 4 over 3. And then negative 4 over 3 is somewhere here, maybe. Negative 4 over 3. Can roughly say that it's that in that area. So now, in order to graph the solution, I will use the, it says here x greater than negative 4 over 3. So this is negative 4 over 3. Open circle because it does not include negative 4 over 3. Greater than means it is going in this direction. And it will stop here because here is x less than 4 over 3. So this is the solution set. And if I want to express it in terms of interval notation, then x must be between negative 4 over 3 and 4 over 3. Okay. Next. Okay, in this case, we are going to look at the problem of inequalities involving absolute value. So when you talk about absolute value, there are four basic cases that need to be considered. So in this example here, in these four cases here, A is the positive number. And of course, this is the inequality symbol, which can be easily changed with either less than or greater than, depending on the question asked. Okay, so for the first one, let's illustrate x less than or equal to a, and here is the absolute value of x greater than or equal to a. So for simplicity or for illustration, let us put a number to a. Let's say a is equal to 3. Okay, so now if I have the graph 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, for example, -1, -2, -3, and so on. So if I have modulus x less than or equal to 3, what are the possible solutions where this statement is true? Now, if x, let's say, at this position, is this statement true? Modulus 2 is 2, 2 is less than 3, the statement is true. If I have this point, -0.4, the statement is no longer true because 4 is actually greater than 3, greater than 3, yeah? So I can see that it will be true when x is 3, it will be less than or equal to 3, so it will stop here. It cannot go further than that. And then if I have -3, for example, so -3, absolute value of -3 is 3, so this is also true. So basically you can see that the solution is from this point until this point. Now we can also take out the absolute value by doing this operation. If you want to take out the absolute value x less than or equal to 3, then taking out the absolute value, you will have plus minus x less than or equal to 3. So essentially it means that positive x less than or equal to 3 and negative x less than or equal to 3. So this is the solution already at its simplified form, but this one, negative x is less than or equal to 3, is similar to x greater than negative 3. So if you write it in terms of interval notation, x is greater than or equal to negative 3, and x is less than 3, and this is similar to what you have seen in this graph, which comprises of this area. Okay, how about the second case? So here I will have modulus x greater than or equal to 3. So let's imagine a real number line. So let's say this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, for example, -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, and so on. So now we are going to imagine what are the values that, you know, make the inequality statement true. Now, this is greater than or equal to 3. So, of course, if I have 4, modulus 4 is greater than or equal to 3. If I have 3, this is also true. This statement is also true. But I cannot have less than that. I cannot have the value 2 here because 2 modulus 2 is going to be less than 3. So I know that this is the values. The minimum is 3 and it can go on this direction. Similarly, if you look at the negative part, negative 3, absolute value of negative 3, you will make this statement still true. If I have absolute value of negative 5, 2 becomes 5, and this statement is also true. So I can see that all the values from this point onwards will make the statement over here true. So these are the solution to the problem. And again, we can simply, when A is positive, when A is positive, 3 and 3, we can take out the absolute value from x by saying that plus minus x greater than or equal to 3. So this means that x greater than or equal to 3 and negative x greater than or equal to 3. So if I want to get rid, I want to find what is x really is, so x must be less than negative 3. So this represents the situation that you have seen here, the area that you have seen here, x less than or equal to negative 3. X greater than 3 is the situation here. So in terms of interval notation, the solution will be negative infinity, negative 3, union 3, infinity. Okay? Alright, so we are done with the first case and second case. We're going to move on to the third case and fourth case, and I'm going to erase this slide. Okay. The third case is modulus x less than or equal to negative a. And the fourth case is modulus x greater than or equal to negative a. And to make it simple, just to illustrate the point, let's say a is equal to 3. Now, if a is equal to 3, what I have here is then modulus x less than or equal to negative 3. So now I'm just going to sketch a real number line here. And consider some of the points 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and so on. So now let's imagine, where are the points that ensure this statement is still true? So if I have 0, x is equal to 0, is it less than negative 3? No, it is not, because it is bigger than negative 3. If I have 4, so modulus 4, is it less than negative 3? It is not true. How about I have negative 3? Negative 3, modulus of negative 3, I'll get 3. 3 is also not less than negative 3. Now you can test that. Okay, what if I have negative 20? Negative 20 is 20. So is 20 less than negative 3? Nope. Okay, what about 15? Modulus 15 is 15. Is it less than negative 3? Nope. So in this situation, actually, there is no solution, because you cannot find a value of x where its absolute value of x will become less than a negative value. So there is no solution. Now, how about this one? So we're looking at this problem, where modulus x is greater than, for example, here is negative 3. So for this one here, no solution. So if I consider a real number line, let's say this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and so on. Now, where are the points that ensure the statement given here is true. Now, if I get 1, consider 1. Modest 1 is greater than negative 3, definitely. If I consider 3, modulus 3 is also greater than negative 3. Negative 3, modulus negative 3 is 3. The statement is true. True. So, in fact, if I consider all the values of x in this number line, this real number line, all these values here will make the statement true. So, for case number 4, x is actually all numbers, okay? Real numbers. So, every x is the solution. Alright, next. Solve this inequality and graph the solution set and express the answer using interval notation. Okay, so now we can consider solving it, okay, easily. This is nothing to do, this is not so much related to what I mean is this is not so complicated actually. So okay, negative 6 plus 3x plus 2 is less than or equal to 0. So now I have 3x plus 2 less than or equal to 6. So now we have a positive number. So A is 6 in this case. So since this is positive, so positive number, therefore in order to get rid of the absolute value sign, I can say plus minus 3x plus 2 is less than or equal to 6. So we are considering two scenarios here. The first one is 3x plus 2 less than 6. The second one is negative 3x plus 2 less than or equal to 6. So for this one, 3x less than 4. X less than 4 over 3. And for this one, 3x plus 2 greater than or equal to negative 6. 3x greater than negative 8. X greater than negative 8 over 3. Okay. So the solution set can be expressed as such, the graph. So you can see that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, for example, 5, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and so on. So 4 over 3 is somewhere closer to 1.5. Okay, maybe here. Maybe this is 4 over 3. And negative 8 over 3 is, a bit, bigger than 2.5 somewhere here. So this is negative 8 over 3. So the solution set is just at this point. Okay, at this point, it includes this point, so full circle. Greater than negative 8 over 3, so it is going in this direction. And this one less than 4 over 3, so less than 4 over 3, so it stops here. So in terms of interval notation, x is negative 8 over 3, you have square bracket until 4 over 3, another square bracket. Alright, the last example in this video, suppose that a contractor charges a flat fee of 1000 plus 120 per hour for a project and he wants to do a job for 8000 or less. What is the maximum number of hours he can work to be able to charge 8,000 or less? So maximum number of hours he can work. So we can represent this with maybe H, number of hours he can work, H. So the total job is 8,000 or less. So how do you get 8,000 or less? You get 8,000 or less if you have charge 1,000 plus 120 times how many hours he will work on that project, and that should be 8,000 or less. 8,000 ringgit. Okay, so based on this, you can continue to solve this inequality statement. 120H less than or equal to 8,000 minus 1,000. So that will be 120H less than 7,000. So H less than 7,000 over 120. So 7,000 over 120 is about H less than or equal to 58.333. So since you're talking about the number of hours, therefore maximum number of hours is 58 hours in order for the contractor to be able to charge the job with 8,000 ringgit or less. Alright, that's the end of chapter 5. Thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you guys on the next video.